Stick with me and I will guarantee you'll never last among the crowd with me. Never last among the crowd with me.
Good morning. Welcome here. Welcome to this Tuesday in my life. My name is Jessica. So wonderful to meet you. I am getting ready for work right now and I thought we could chat. Even though it's Tuesday, it's kind of like a Monday today because we had Monday off. So first day of the work week on a Tuesday. How fun is that? And I know this foundation is way too white. Sometimes you just accidentally buy the wrong shade and then I'm just dealing with it. So the first day of the work week is always kind of fun because we have a Monday meeting. We are going to be discussing our quarter one goals at today's meeting, which is really important. Like in our company, I love how intentional and focused it all is. Like the company has quarterly goals. We as individuals have quarterly goals. And it's just a really good thing. I am looking forward to discussing that and kind of getting a fresh vision and focus for this new quarter. And you know, beginning of the year is always an exciting time because you're just refocusing on your goals and dreams and desires. And I feel like the beginning of this year has been one of breakthrough for me. I was having a really hard time in Q4 of last year. Like it just, I was going through a dark night of the soul. For me, it was questioning like, what is my purpose? Because I've had some dreams. I've wanted to be a mom and I thought I would have gotten there by now, but I have not. So having a career was never something that I envisioned myself doing. Like I thought I would be a mom and then do this little thing on the side, but that hasn't materialized. Having kids hasn't been the instant thing that you think it should be, right? People get pregnant all the time. So never would have expected that we would have any problems with that. Anyways, Q4, these thoughts were running through my head of like, if I haven't gotten my dream yet, then maybe it'll never happen. Maybe I've missed my purpose. I kind of lost hope there for a minute. I lost my purpose for life. At least I thought I did. But praise the Lord, He has helped me work through that. I was brain detoxing and have come out to a really good space, I feel, where like, I know God gave me the dream to be a mom. And if He did it, then He will also bring it to fruition. I don't know how, but I believe He will. Besides, like all the stories in the Bible of women who were barren were all in the Bible to then show God's greatness through bringing them children. Felt like he gave me that. He's like, all these stories of women in the Bible, they all end up with kids. That is for you. Yeah. Just holding on to that and coming through this dark time, it's come out to a very, very exciting thing this year. And a big part of that is having the vlog and just being able to share what I'm going through, because I have no doubt many of you watching right now have either been in a season or are in a season currently where you feel like disappointed. Like the dreams that you thought were yours for the taking, like your life was gonna be XYZ, and it hasn't turned out yet. And that can be so hard. That can be so, so hard. And Proverbs says it well, that hope deferred makes the heart sick. So that brings us back to like, what are we hoping in? And the thing is, you can never rely on things. can never rely on things. We have to rely on the Creator. Anyways, I am just completely rambling now, so let me just undo my hair. And after this, I'm going to be doing a live Bible reading because I am part of a group that is reading through the Bible in a year. So on Tuesdays, basically every second Tuesday, I will read the portion of the day, and that is live streamed on YouTube as well as Facebook. It's in the Fear Into Faith Facebook group. So if you are into reading the Bible, if you've ever wanted to read the Bible in a year, this is a great challenge to be a part of, and you can listen to the live stream readings. They are at 9 a.m. Eastern time, so you can translate for your own time zone there. But I gotta hurry up and undo my hair.
There we are.
We are live. So our reading for the day is 2 Chronicles 4 through 7. This is an amazing passage. Bible reading is done. We had a whole, whoopsies. Nope. Trying to log out from StreamYard. And we had so much good prayer and discussion at the end. That was really, really good. But now I only have a couple more minutes before I need to leave for work, so I better run. Well, we are back home for a quick lunch break. Thankfully, I work pretty close to where I live, so I can just run home for lunch. that also helps because I'm kind of lazy and I don't want to pack a lunch. So I have a random conglomeration of leftovers. It'll be great. So I know presentation is zero, but it does taste really good. I have homemade hummus here, zucchini and mushrooms and onions, sauerkraut, sweet potato, and this is just some turkey. Completely random, but it gets the job done. So I am just going to eat this and watch a little bit of Michelle read. Rachel Vinn is going over to her place, so that is super fun. Two of my most watched YouTubers in the same video. You gotta love it.
Always do on our Monday meeting is to establish our big three for the week. This is based off of Michael Hyatt's planning system, Full Focus Planner. You break down all of your goals into quarterly, weekly goals. So we always decide what's our big three. Those are the big things that we're going to do. I like to write that on a sticky note and stick it on my computer. So I always have right in front of my face what my focus for the week is. From there, we always determine what the big three for the day are.
Ah, it is 4:30 and I am home from work, and I have an hour more than I thought I was going to have because the 4:30 meeting that I was going to have has been canceled. My friend is in Snowland and their power has been going out all day. So, not the most reliable environment for an important business meeting that we were going to have. So, now I get to figure out what else I will do for the rest of the day. Obviously, studying for the SIE, that's pretty important. And I have some insurance documents that I want to review. Now, I am actually really excited about this. And you may think I'm crazy because, like, insurance, Oh boy, who loves insurance? Just you wait. Ugh, I've heard about this type of insurance policy for some time now, where it was like you can overfund the policy and then you can take out some of the, you know, the policy value as a loan. And then when you pay back the loan, you're actually paying back yourself and you pay interest to yourself. So it just like gives you more and more money back instead of paying another company. I had heard of this concept for a while and was just like, where do you find that information? Like, how do you even start looking about that stuff? I don't even know. And then my husband went to coffee with a friend and they were talking about this stuff. And our friend had multiple of these policies and connected us with their insurance provider. So I am reading into these policies, I'm researching them. I want to understand in and out how they work, because I work for a financial advisor. We don't really do insurance. We can do insurance, but we don't really do it. But if I can understand how these policies work, this could be hugely beneficial to people, because like not everyone has $1 million to invest right off the bat, but how do you start growing that, you know, how do you start growing that capital? You can use it to make loans and pay interest to yourself on the loan and pay dividends to yourself from that loan. Instead of buying a car with a car loan company and paying them all the interest, you can pay yourself. Oh, I'm super excited about this. Anyways, this is called the Infinity Banking Concept. There's this book called Be Your Own Banker, the Infinity Banking Concept, something like that. I will link it below, the physical copy, I bought that, and the Audible copy, I bought that too. The thing about the Audible version is that he references like figures and charts that you can't see unless you're looking at a book. So that's why I bought both, and that's why I recommend both, and I will link them down below. If you don't have an investment plan yet, check this out, because I'm looking at it for my own investment plan. Okay? Okay. Enough about that. I am making toast, and I'm gonna have toast and hummus for a snack, and then I'm gonna do my studying and all this good stuff.
Truth be told is I've never felt better, and if I'm honest with myself, I am so glad we're together, because this new state of mind that I've struggled to find can now be shared with you, because you showed me the light.
Well, we finished reading through 10 pages. I took a break partway in between and took a nap because I was just falling asleep. I took a nap and then I made myself some golden milk tea with coconut milk, mind you. My husband will be home in a little less than an hour. So in that time, I will make supper and I don't know, I should probably be productive. Actually, I have laundry to fold. Yeah, that's a good idea. Let's do that.
Radio up and the blinds pulled down. You love it when nobody's around. I wanna call out pound town, but you bite my lip, don't make a sound. I'll be damned if I'm leaving without you. My breath.
take what's yours, I'll take what's left. I'm used to coming up second best, always fail to pass the test.
Now it's time to make supper, but thankfully it'll be really simple. It's just gonna be leftovers. I have some rice and that turkey breast meat that I was eating for lunch today. It's like Mexican spiced-ish. So thankfully I can just put that together and make a quick salad, and that'll be great because my husband's gonna be here in like 10 minutes and he sent me a message. He's like, I'm gonna be hungry when I get home. It'd be great if you had food ready. So yeah, thankfully it's gonna be real quick.
Trust you, I don't need to understand. Make me your vessel, make me an offering, make me whatever you want me to be.
Well, that was a really good supper and a good evening. We basically just sat at the table and chatted for a bit. I was doing some Pinterest surfing for 2023 vision board inspo that I've been working on. You can probably see this thingy in the background. That was a vision board that I made last year. This year I'm doing a little bit different. Some of the things that are going to be on that vision board are powerful, but we'll talk more about that later. So, good night for now. Thank you for joining me on this day in the life. If you enjoyed the video, please like, leave a comment below. I would love to see you around. We are going to be having a little vision board video coming up in the future. In that one, we're also going to talk about vision in general and finding your purpose, because that's been a whole journey for me lately. So we're going to be diving into that and what the journey could look like in finding your purpose, and a little bit of, I don't know, counterculture, counter success thoughts. Yeah. So if you want to watch that, please feel free to stick around and subscribe. But if not, I wish you a good night. We'll see you in the next video.